فَعَلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مُتَقَلَّبَكُمْ وَمَثْوَاكُمْ.
أن أمته ستفترق على 73 فرقة كلها في النار إلا واحدة، وهي من كان على مثل ما عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأصحابه. ولا يهولنك كثرة الجمع، فالحق هو الحق، وإن لم يأخذ به إلا واحد.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the ever merciful. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praise is due to Allah, the Lord, creator and sustainer of all things. Wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafi anbiya illahi sayyidil mursaleen. May Allah raise the rank of and grant peace to the most honored of all prophets of Allah and the chief of the messengers, Nabiyina Muhammad, our Prophet Muhammad, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in, and likewise the family and companions of the Prophet Muhammad. Amma ba'd, as for what follows, then by the grace and permission of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala alone, we return together here locally at al-Masjid al-Awwal in the city of Pittsburgh via tele-link with our brothers at the Tarbiyah initiative of South Florida. May Allah ta'ala grant them and their da'wah success. We come together on Saturday nights to study from the great book al-Usool al-Thalaathah, the three fundamental principles, by the great scholar Shaykh al-Islaam Muhammad ibn Abdil-Wahhaab at-Tamimi rahimahullahu ta'ala. And in our previous sessions of this course, we've taken a number of classes on some details about our belief in the last day, in the discussion of the six pillars of Iman from the hadith of Jibreel alayhi as-salam. And our last discussion was a very interesting and beneficial one, involving a reading of five Quranic passages from Surah Al-Baqarah, wherein Allah Ta'ala described factually and historically accurately five events where the dead were brought back to life, in this world. Not the dead coming back to life in the hereafter, but the dead coming back to life in hayat al-dunya, in this worldly life. And following that interesting and enlightening discussion, we return to our reading of the explanation of al-Usool al-Thalaathah by al-Allama Muhammad ibn Saalih and al-Uthaymeen rahimahullahu ta'ala. We've reached in his printed explanation of this wonderful book, page number 107. And so we pick up where we left off, right in the middle of the page, where the Shaykh rahimahullahu ta'ala said, وَأَمَّا دِلَالَةُ الْعَقْلِ, as for intellectual proofs for the possibility of and the reality of the dead coming back to life after death, فَمِنْ وَجْهَيْنِ, and that's from two basic angles. أَحَدُهُمَا, the first of those two angles, أَنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى فَاطِرُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, that Allah is the originating creator of the heavens and the earth. وَمَا فِيهِمَا, and everything in them. خَالِقُهُمَا ابْتِدَاءً, he's the creator of the heavens and the earth and all of that. ابْتِدَاءً, meaning initially, from the origination of the heavens and the earth, without anything preceding them. وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَى ابْتِدَاءِ الْخَلْقِ, and so rationally speaking here, the one who's capable about beginning the creation from nothing, creating them from nothing, لَا يَعْجَزُ عَنْ إِعَادَتِهِ, he would not be incapable of bringing that creation back to life, since he has created it from nothing in the first place. قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى, Allah the Most High has said, وَهُوَ الَّذِي يَبْدَأُ الْخَلْقَ ثُمَّ يُعِيدُهُ, He's the one who began the creation, and then he shall return it. وَهُوَ أَهْوَنُ عَلَيْهِ. And that return, bringing people back to life after their death, that's easier for him, logically, and here, textually as well. That's from Surah Ar-Rum, the 27th verse. وَقَالَ تَعَالَىٰ. And Allah has said as well, and He is the Most High, كَمَا بَدَأْنَا أَوَّلَ خَلْقٍ نُعِيدُ. Just as we began the very first creation, we shall repeat it, return it. وَعْدًا عَلَيْنَا. A promise upon us to fulfill. إِنَّا كُنَّا فَاعِلِينَ. And verily, we are certainly going to do that. Allah Ta'ala speaks with the royal plural there in Surah Al-Anbiya, the 104th verse. وَقَالَ آمِرًا بِالرَّدِّ عَلَىٰ مَنْ أَنْكَرَ إِحْيَاءَ الْعِظَامِ وَهِيَ رَمِيمٌ. And he has said as well, ordering his believing servants to respond to those who deny life after death, life being given to bones that are scattered about. He has said, قُلْ يُحْيِيهَا الَّذِي أَنْشَأَهَا أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ. Say in response to them, the one who will bring them back to life, the one who will give them life, is the one who created them the very first time. وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ خَلْقٍ عَلِيمٍ. And he is regarding everything that has been created, all knowledgeable. That's from Surah Yasin, the 79th verse. That's the first angle, the rational or intellectual angle of understanding that the dead shall indeed be brought back to life and there will be account and reward. Athani, the second intellectual angle to understand that reality. أَنَّ الْأَرْضَ تَكُونُ مَيْتَةً هَامِدَةً. That the earth, meaning that you can see, it becomes in a state of being dead. Everything on it, the life upon it is dead. Lifeless, still, without any life on it. لَيْسَ فِيهِ شَجَرَةٌ خَضْرَاءٌ. You find not a single plant that's alive on a certain part of the earth. And we are in the middle of the winter and we see that. All of the trees that were full of life in the summer are just like cracked sticks poking up out of the ground, subhanAllah. Like they're dead. فَيَنْزِلُ عَلَيْهَا الْمَطَرُ فَتَهْتَزُّ خَضَرَاءَ حَيَّةً. So then the rain comes down upon them, meaning in the springtime, the rain comes down, or you could say here in a drought-ridden place as well, not necessarily wintertime. But you see the vegetation all cracked and dead and dried up. And then the rain comes down, either the rain of the springtime after the frozen winter, or the rain after a drought, it comes. And what does it do? It begins to produce vegetation. The earth then shakes and it vibrates. And you see the green vegetation coming alive. فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ زَوْجٍ بَهِيجٍ. And you'll find in that vegetation every type of vegetation that comes in pairs, in beautiful pairs. وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَىٰ إِحْيَائِهَا. And the one who's capable of bringing that back to life, بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا, after all of that has died, قَادِرٌ عَلَىٰ إِحْيَاءِ الْأَمْوَاتِ. He is then as well capable of bringing back the humans who have died after their death. قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَىٰ. Allah the Most High has said, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنَّكَ تَرَى الْأَرْضَ خَاشِعَةً. And from His signs is that you see the earth in humility, in humble submission. فَإِذَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْهَا الْمَاءَ. And when we send down upon it water, meaning rain, اِهْتَزَّتْ وَرَبَتْ. Then it shakes and produces an increase, meaning it increases in green vegetation. إِنَّ الَّذِي أَحْيَاهَا. Verily the one who brought it back to life, لَمُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى. Then he shall bring the dead back to life, meaning the dead people. إِنَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. He is certainly above all things with masterful capabilities. That's from Surah Fussilat, the 39th verse. وَقَالَ تَعَالَىٰ. And Allah the Most High has said, وَنَزَّلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً مُبَارَكًا. And we send down repetitively again and again from the heavens, blessed water, فَأَنْبَتْنَا بِهِ جَنَّاتٍ وَحَبَّ الْحَصِيدِ, and we bring forth as vegetation through that water, gardens and the seeds that bring forth harvests, وَالنَّخْلَ بَاسِقَاتٍ, and date palm trees that are so tall, لَهَا طَلْعٌ نَوِيدٌ, they have offshoots of fruits that are lined up in a very organized lining. رِزْقًا لِلْعِبَادِ, provisions for the worshippers, for the servants. وَأَحْيَيْنَا بِهِ بَلْدَةً مَيْتًا, and through that we have given life to a land that is dead. كَذَلِكَ الْخُرُوجِ, and just like that is the khuruj, meaning the resurrection and the return of mankind from their graves to stand in front of Allah for account. And that is from Surah Qaf, the 9th through 11th verses. In these passages we see quite clearly that Allah Ta'ala teaches us and invites us to use our intellect to compare things that we have seen in this life to what will come in the hereafter. To see that there is a foundation indeed for the dead coming back to life, as we have seen, and we shall see it in the hereafter, whether we believe in it in this life or not. As Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen, he continues to say here, وَقَدْ ضَلَّ قَوْمٌ مِنْ أَهْلِ الزَّيْغِ, there are people of deviation who have gone astray in this topic, فَأَنْكَرُوا عَذَابَ الْقَبْرِ, and they have denied the punishment of the grave, وَنَعِيمَهُ, and the delight of the believers in the grave, زَاعِمِينَ أَنَّ ذَلِكَ غَيْرُ مُمْكِنٍ, and they assume with that assumption of theirs that that's not possible. And here we're talking about those who ascribe to Islam and those who say they believe in the hereafter, but this part of the hereafter they deny it and they refuse to believe in it. That is the life of the grave. They are most notably the Khawarij and the Mu'tazila, and there are others as well. They say it's not possible لِمُخَالَفَةِ الْوَاقِعِ, because it goes against reality. What do they mean? قَالُوا, they said, فَإِنَّهُ لَوْ كُشِفَ عَنِ الْمَيِّتِ فِي قَبْرِهِ, if a person were to have his grave dug up, unearthed, لَوُجِدَ كَمَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ, then you will find him in that situation just as he was when he was buried. وَالْقَبْرُ لَمْ يَتَغَيَّرْ بِسَاعَةٍ وَلَا ضِيقٍ, and the grave has physically not changed to become more spacious or to become more constricted and tight upon him. What's the problem? They're using worldly analogies. Between spheres, between planes of existence, subhanAllah, going from one plane of existence, al-hayatu dunya, into al-hayatul akhirah, into the hereafter, one plane, one actual realm of existence that's part of the hereafter, that which is a barrier between the dunya and the everlasting hereafter, subhanAllah. So they're saying, we see the dead in the ground, and they've been dug up, and they are just bones, and there's no big, wide, spacious, bright grave with someone enjoying things in there, nor is there any constricted, smashed grave on anyone who's being tortured or punished. So based on this then, they say this must mean that the texts are not actually accurate, because reality is in contradiction to those texts. وَهَذَا زَعَمُ بَاطِلٌ بِالشَّرْعِ وَالْحِسِّ وَالْعَقْلِ, and that assumption is false from, here he mentions three angles. The shara, meaning textual evidences from the book and the sunnah. The his, meaning what you can see and touch and what you can feel, or what has been reported based on sensory perception. Wa al-aql, and as well intellectual, pure, untainted, rational thinking with the fitrah that is intact and not changed and corrupted. Amma shara'u, as for textual evidences from the book and the sunnah, فَقَدْ سَبَقَتِ النُّصُوصُ الدَّالَّةُ عَلَى ثُبُوتِ عَذَابِ الْقَبْرِ, then it's already preceded the textual evidences that prove that the punishment of the grave is indeed a reality. وَنَعِيمِهِ فِي فَقْرَةِ بَاءٍ, and as well the delight of the grave. That's been proven in the paragraph B, you could say, مِمَّا يَلْتَحِقُ بِالْإِيمَانِ بِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ, as it relates to the issues that were mentioned under our faith in the last day. وَفِي صَحِيحِ الْبُخَارِيِّ مِنْ حَدِيثِ ابْنِ عَبَّاسٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمَا قَالَ, and as well in the authentic hadith compilation of Sahih al-Bukhari from the narration of Abdullah ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, he said, خرج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من بعض حيطان المدينة, the Prophet, may Allah raise his rank and grant him peace, went out from some of the buildings of al-Madinah, فسمع صوت إنسانين يعذبان في قبورهما, and then he heard the sounds of two people, two human beings, being tortured in their graves. وَذَكَرَ الْحَدِيثِ, and he mentioned that narration. وَفِيهِ أَنَّ أَحَدَهُمَا كَانَ لَا يَسْتَطِرُ مِنَ الْبَوْلِ, and in that narration is his mention that one of them used to not protect himself from his urine. وَفِي رِوَايَةٍ, in one version of the narration, مِنْ بَوْلِهِ, from his urine, versus urine. وَأَنَّ الْآخَرَ كَانَ يَمْشِي بِالنَّمِيمَةِ, and as for the other, then he used to carry tales between the people. He used to say certain things to certain people that would cause animosity and hatred between them. Now, in that hadith, the point of the author is, these were two people in their graves being described by the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as-sadiq al-masduq, may Allah raise his rank and grant him peace, the one who's truthful and always believed in, الذي لا ينطق عن الهوى إن هو إلا وحي يوحى, the one who does not speak from his own accord, it is but revelation that has been sent to him. So when he spoke about this matter, it's not possible to assume that he was in error, or he was delusional, or he was mistaken, or inaccurate in what he was reporting. This is our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describing what was going on in the grave. وَأَمَّا الْحِسُّ, and as for sensory perception, فَإِنَّ النَّائِمَ, think about this, the person sleeping, يَرَى فِي مَنَامِهِ, he sees dreams, أَنَّهُ كَانَ فِي مَكَانٍ فَسِيحٍ بَهِيجٍ يَتَنَاعَمُ فِيهِ, he sees that he's in a place that's wide and spacious and beautiful, and he's enjoying it, he's enjoying his stay there. أو أنه كان في مكان ضيق موحش يتألم منه, or he sees that he's in a tight, restricted place he's unfamiliar and uncomfortable with, and he's in pain as a result of being in that place. وربما يستيقظ أحيانا مما رأى, and perhaps he may wake up, come out of his dream in fear, you know, because of what he has seen. ومع ذلك, and with that, and at that state right there, فَهُوَ عَلَى فِرَاشِهِ, he is in fact upon his bed, فِي حُجْرَتِهِ, in his room, عَلَى مَا هُوَ عَلَيْهِ, just as he is in his bed, right, not like what he saw. وَالنَّوْمُ أَخُ الْمَوْتِ, and sleep is the sister of death, or the brother of death, meaning something that resembles death, like the twin brother of death. وَلِهَذَا سَمَّاهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى وَفَاتًا, and because of this reality, the connection between sleep and death, Allah has named sleep wafat, a type of the soul being taken, a type of death. قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى, Allah the Most High has said, اللَّهُ يَتَوَفَّى الْأَنفُسَ حِينَ مَوْتِهَا, Allah is the one who takes the souls at the time of their death. وَالَّتِي لَمْ تَمُتْ, and he takes the souls as well of those who haven't died. فِي مَنَامِهَا, in their sleep. فَيُمْسِكُ الَّتِي قَضَى عَلَيْهَا الْمَوْتِ, and so he keeps the soul of the one that has had death become a verdict upon it, meaning that which has been ruled upon to die. وَيُرْسِلُ الْأُخْرَى إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى, and then he returns the other one back to an appointed time of respite. And that's from Surah Az-Zumar, the 42nd verse. وَأَمَّا الْعَقَلِ, And as for rational, intellectual thought, that which is from untainted, uncorrupted people, فَإِنَّ النَّائِمَةَ, then that is based on the sleeping person, فِي مَنَامِهِ يَرَى الرُّؤْيَا الْحَقَّ الْمُطَابِقَةَ لِلْمَوَاقِعِ. And the person sees in his dream a true dream, that which actually applies to what happens in reality, a true dream. وَرُبَّمَا رَأَى النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَلَى صِفَتِهِ. And perhaps he may see the Prophet, may Allah raise his rank and grant him peace, with his actual description as he was. وَمَنْ رَآهُ عَلَى صِفَتِهِ فَقَدْ رَآهُ حَقًّا. And whoever sees him with his real description, then he has seen him in reality, in truth. وَمَعَ ذَلِكَ فَالنَّائِمُ فِي حُجْرَتِهِ. And along with that, the sleeping person is in his room. عَلَى فِرَاشِهِ, on his bed. بَعِيدًا عَنْ مَا رَأَى, far away from what he has seen in his dream. فَإِنْ كَانَ هَذَا مُمْكِنًا فِي أَحْوَالِ الدُّنْيَا. So if that is possible as it relates to what happens with situations in this worldly life, أَفَلَا يَكُونُ مُمْكِنًا فِي أَحْوَالِ الْآخِرَةِ, then should it not be possible as it relates to the affairs of the hereafter? وَأَمَّا اعْتِمَادُهُمْ, and as for their relying, فِيمَا زَعَمُوهُ, in what they have assumed and guessed, عَلَى أَنَّهُ لَوْ كُشِفَ عَنِ الْمَيِّتِ فِي قَبْرِهِ, that if they were to exhume the grave of a dead person, take his body out of the grave, لَوُجِدَ كَمَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ, they would find him in the same situation that they buried him with. وَالْقَبْرُ لَمْ يَتَغَيَّرْ بِسَاعَةٍ وَلَا ضِيقٍ, and the grave hasn't changed, becoming more expansive or becoming tighter. That's their claim that we introduced. فَجَوَابُهُ مِنْ وُجُوهٍ, then the response to that claim is from a number of angles. مِنْهَا, from those angles. الْأَوَّلُ, the first one. أَنَّهُ لَا تَجُوزُ مُعَارَضَةُ مَا جَاءَ بِهِ الشَّرْعُ. It is not allowed, it's not permissible to contradict that which has come in authentic textual evidence. بِمِثْلِ هَذِهِ الشُّبُهَاتِ الدَّاحِضَةِ الَّتِي لَوْ تَأَمَّلَ الْمُعَارِضُ بِهَا مَا جَاءَ بِهِ الشَّرْعُ حَقَّ تَأَمُّلُ. With these types of false doubts, that which if a person who was actually opposing the texts would think carefully about the texts, حَقَّ تَأَمَّلُ, with true proper reflection, لَعَلِمَ بُطْرَانَ هَذِهِ الشُّبُهَاتِ, then he would know the falsehood of these false claims or these false arguments. وَقَدْ قِيلَ, and it has been said, and he mentions a line of poetry here, وَكَمْ مِنْ عَائِبٍ قَوْلًا صَحِيحًا, and how often is it that someone finds fault with a correct statement. وَآفَتُهُ مِنَ الْفَهْمِ السَّقِيمِ, but the problem, the reason that led him to reject that thing, which was actually true, was the fault in the person's poor understanding. It was a faulty, sickening understanding of the scenario that led him to reject the reality. So then from the shortcoming of the person, from his lack of ability to understand affairs of the unseen, he rejects a true reality. That will come to him and he will see. Athani, the second angle to reject this false assumption, that because the physical situation of the dead person in the grave cannot be detected from our perspective, that it must be not true, the punishment and the reward of the grave must be false. أَنَّ أَحْوَالَ الْبَرْزَخِ مِنْ أُمُورِ الْغَيْبِ, the affairs of the grave, they are from the affairs of the unseen. أَلَّتِي لَا يُدْرِكُهَا الْحِسُّ, those that are not detected by sensory perception, meaning in this life, our hearing and our eyesight does not pick up these things. وَلَوْ كَانَتْ تُدْرَكُ بِالْحِسُّ, and had these matters been detectable by sensory perception, لَفَاتَتْ فَائِدَةُ الْإِيمَانِ بِالْغَيْبِ, then there would be no benefit in the concept of believing in the unseen. Meaning believers could not be praised for believing in the unseen because that's not really unseen anymore. It's something detectable and something you can see. وَلَتَسَاوَى الْمُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَالْجَاحِدُونَ فِي التَّصْدِيقِ بِهَا, then the believers would actually be equal to the atheists and those who reject the truth as it relates to their understanding and their affirmation of these matters. Since they are detectable and you can see them, a believer is now equal to a disbeliever. All of them must acknowledge what they see and hear. The third angle to reject this false argument, al-Thalithu anna al-Adhab wal-Na'ima wa sa'at al-Qabri wa dhiqahu. These matters of the punishment and the delight of the grave, as well as the expansiveness of the grave and its tightness, إِنَّمَا يُدْرِكُهَا الْمَيِّتُ دُونَ غَيْرِهِ. It is something that the dead person himself shall witness and be part of and experience, and he alone does that, not those who remain living in this world. وَهَذَا كَمَا يَرَى النَّائِمُ فِي مَنَامِهِ. And this is similar to how the sleeping person sees in his dream, أَنَّهُ فِي مَكَانٍ ضَيِّقٍ مُوَحَّشٍ. That he is in a place that is restricted and unfamiliar and scary. أَوْ فِي مَكَانٍ وَاسِعٍ بَهِيجٍ. Or that he's in a place that is wide open and beautiful. وَهُوَ بِالنِّسْبَةِ لِغَيْرِهِ لَمْ يَتَغَيَّرْ مَنَامُهُ هُوَ فِي حُجْرَتِهِ. He is, as it relates to other people, as he is, he has not changed. He is in his room. وَبَيْنَ فِرَاشِهِ وَغِطَائِهِ. And he's between his bed and his cover. وَلَقَدْ كَانَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. And the Prophet, may Allah raise his rank and grant him peace, يُوحَى إِلَيْهِ. Should say يُوحَى إِلَيْهِ, not يُوحِي إِلَيْهِ. يُوحَى إِلَيْهِ وَهُوَ بَيْنَ أَصْحَابِهِ. He would receive wahi, revelation, whilst he was amongst his companions. فَيَسْمَعُ الْوَحِي. He would hear a sound of revelation. وَلَا يَسْمَعُهُ الصَّحَابَةُ. But the companions would not hear anything. وَرُبَّمَا يَتَمَثَلُ لَهُ الْمَلَكُ رَجُلًا فَيُكَلِّمُهُ. And perhaps sometimes the angel, Jibreel, would shapeshift into a human form and speak to him. وَالصَّحَابَةُ لَا يَرَوْنَ الْمَلَكَ. And the companions would not see the angel. وَلَا يَسْمَعُونَهُ, nor would they hear him. الرَّابِعُ. The fourth angle to reject this false claim. Again, the claim is, since we don't see any movement in the ground or any change in the state of the grave, the dead person or the area around him, then those things about what's happening in the grave must be false. The fourth angle, a rational angle through which we can reject this argument, is أَنَّ إِدْرَاكَ الْخَلْقِ مَحْدُودٌ. That what mankind, or what the people can detect, the creation, what they actually detect, is very limited anyway. بِمَا مَكَّنَهُمَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى مِنْ إِدْرَاكِهِ. And it's limited to what Allah gives them the ability to ascertain and to hear and to listen to or to see. وَلَا يُمْكِنُ أَن يُدْرِكُوا كُلَّ مَوْجُودٍ. And they are not capable. They don't have the capability of attaining knowledge of every single thing that can be perceived and everything in existence. فَالسَّمَاوَاتُ السَّبْعُ وَالْأَرْضُ وَمَنْ فِيهِنَّ. For example, the seven heavens, the earth, and everyone in those things. وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِ اللَّهِ تَسْبِيحًا حَقِيقِيًا. All of them declare the greatness of Allah, exonerate Allah beyond deficiencies. They make tasbih of Allah, and they praise Allah with a tasbih that is haqiqi, with a real tasbih, because Allah has reported that to us. يُسْمِعُهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى مَنْ شَاءَ مِنْ خَلْقِهِ أَحْيَانًا. And Allah allows some of His creation to hear that in some circumstances. We're studying on Sundays the tafsir of Surah An-Naml. And we've just reached the story of Sulaiman and the ants. And how Sulaiman could hear the ants warning each other about the arrival of Sulaiman and his troops. So Allah Ta'ala, this is one example of what the Shaykh is talking about. Allah Ta'ala gave Sulaiman specifically the ability to hear the ants and the ability to understand their language that they were using amongst themselves. وَمَعَ ذَٰلِكَ, Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen continues, along with this, هُوَ مَحْجُوبٌ عَنَّا. It is something that is hidden from us. وَفِي ذَٰلِكَ يَقُولُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. And regarding that, Allah the Most High has said, تُسَبِّحُ لَهُ السَّمَاوَاتُ السَّبْعُ وَالْأَرْضُ وَمَنْ فِيهِنَّ. Everyone in the seven heavens and everyone upon earth declares his greatness and perfection. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ And there is not a single thing إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ Except that it extols Allah's greatness, praising Allah, declaring Allah free of deficiencies. وَلَكِن لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ However, you do not understand their tasbih, their exoneration of Allah. That's from Surah Al-Isra, the 44th verse. وَهَكَذَا الشَّيَاطِينَ And like this are the shayateen, the devils, wal jinn, and the whole race of jinn kind. يَسْعَوْنَ فِي الْأَرْضِ ذَهَابًا وَإِيَابًا They go about the earth, coming and going. وَقَدْ حَضَرَتِ الْجِنُّ إِلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ And some of the jinn, they came to the presence of the Messenger of Allah. May Allah raise his rank and grant him peace. وَاسْتَمَعُوا لِقِرَاءَتِهِ And they listened to his recitation of the Qur'an. وَأَنْصَتُوا And they became quiet in their earnest listening to that. وَوَلَّوْا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِمْ مُنذِرِينَ And they turned back after hearing that, going back to their tribes and their relatives as warners, conveying the message of the Qur'an. وَمَعَ هَذَا And along with this, فَهُمْ مَحْجُوبُونَ عَنَّا They are something screened from us. We don't see these realities. وَفِي ذَٰلِكَ يَقُولُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى And regarding that, Allah the Most High says, يَا بَنِي آدَمَ لَا يَفْتِنَنَّكُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ كَمَا أَخْرَجَ أَبَوَيْكُمْ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ O children of Adam, do not allow the shaytan, the devil, to put you to trial as he caused your parents to be exiled from the Jannah, the paradise. يَنْزِعُ عَنْهُمَا لِبَاسَهُمَا لِيُرِيَهُمَا سَوْآتِهِمَا He would cause them to take off their garments in order for them to see their nakedness. إِنَّهُ يَرَاكُمْ Here's the point of reference. Verily he, shaytan, he sees you. هُوَ وَقَبِيلُهُ Along with his armies or his tribes. مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا تَرَوْنَهُمْ From where you do not see them. إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا الشَّيَاطِينَ أَوْلِيَاءَ لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ Verily we have made the shayateen, the devils, as allies, friends and protectors of those who do not believe. That's from Surah Al-A'raf, the 27th verse. And we conclude with this statement of the Shaykh here, وَإِذَا كَانَ الْخَلْقُ لَا يُدْرِكُونَ كُلَّ مَوْجُودٍ Since it's the case that the creation, the entire creation is not able to detect and perceive or listen to everything in existence, فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَجُوزُ أَن يُنْكِرُوا مَا ثَبَتَ مِنْ أُمُورِ الْغَيْبِ وَلَمْ يُدْرِكُوهُ How could they then believe they could reject things that exist in planes of existence that are unseen to us, and they are things they haven't been able to detect? How could they reject those when there are things that are happening in their same plane of existence that they are unable to detect? And that's the fourth and final rational argument offered by Shaykh Muhammad ibn Saalih al-Uthaymeen. And by the grace of Allah Ta'ala and His favor upon us, we have completed our reading of the explanation of the Shaykh on the topic of belief in the last day. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك